Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Charles B. Dyer Airedale Arena and tonight's conference matchup between the Lady Goblins of Harrison and your Alma Lady Airedales. Before we begin tonight's action, we will have a moment of silence followed by the recitation of the Pledge of Allegiance and then the presentation of our national anthem. This time, we ask that you please rise and remove cover and join us in a moment of silence. Thank you. Now please turn your attention to the south end of the arena, high up in the rafters, as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now presenting our national anthem this evening is your Airedale Pep Band. And now it's time to introduce the starting lineups. First, for our visitors from Harrison, a sophomore, number 2, Brooklyn Mitchell. Sophomore, number 25, Eliza Barger. A junior, number 24, Tucker Webb. Junior, number 32, Lila Jones. And a senior, number 12, Annabelle Massengale. Fans, it's time to make some noise as we introduce the starting lineup for your Alma Lady Airedales. First up is a senior, number 3, McKinley McCart. Next up is a sophomore, number 4, B.L.I. Hughes. A senior, number 10, Kylie Poole. A junior, number 23, Jaden Gramlich. And a junior, number 33, Jordan Gramlich. Assistant coaches for the Lady Airedales are Allie Smith and Garrett King. Their head coach, Chandley Bottoms.
And good evening, everyone. We are ready for some basketball tonight. The 5A West opener of this doubleheader features the Harrison Lady Goblins and the Alma Lady Airedales. And the first shot is a three-point shot. It's good for Harrison. Harrison coming off a win the last time these teams played, 61-30 against those Lady Airedales. And now I'm a little bit shorthanded that game, just 8 players, but everybody back in there tonight. And the Goblins come out firing away, three-point shots up and good. Harrison team was coached by Stacy Klott. It's her 4th season as the head coach. And Lady Airedales Chanley Bottoms her first year as the head coach. Here's a three-point shot for Alma. It's on the way. It's no good. The rebound is taken down by the Goblins. Here comes Harrison on the run. They get it down low and lost it. Pick it back up. Three-point shot's on the way. It's good. Goodness, this is unbelievable. Van Buren, it's 14 threes on Tuesday night. And Harrison comes in here like it's her own gym and hits two in a row to make it 6-0, and the Airedales turn it over. 6 minutes and 49 seconds left here in the first quarter of play. The standings in the 5A West, Russellville 6-1. Greenwood is 5-1. Mountain Home at 6-1. Harrison 3-3. And Van Buren at 3-4. Greenbrier 3-4. Alma 1-6. And Salem Springs 0-7. That's the first round coming to an end. They still got a few games to make up. Six nothing start for Harrison. They got to shoot it. Got five on the shot clock, down to four. They drive and a reach in foul with 2 seconds on the clock, and they're bailed out. First foul against the Lady Airedales here in the first quarter of play. That's on Kylie Poole. First foul to start this game. Harrison's next shot, three-point shot's no good. They get the rebound, put it back in. It's good, no good, and the rebound tapped out and saved. But off of Alma, it's going to stay with Harrison, I think. Maybe a reach-in foul. Nope, it's going to stay with Harrison. So the Goblins have it, a lot of size. That's kind of been the one problem the Lady Airedales have not had much of, no size. Here's a shot in the lane, up and in. Basket made by number 25. That's Eliza Barger. Now we're trying to get it down the floor, and ball's tipped out of bounds. Timeout, Chanley Bottoms. So 5:49 left to play in the first quarter. It's 8-0. Harrison on top of the Lady Airedales here from the Charles B. Dyer Arena on a Friday night. We've had all kinds of sorts of weather in this basketball season. We had cold Alaska winter about 3 weeks ago, and today it's like 71 degrees, so I don't know. Hard to figure out the weather sometimes. They all say that. Just wait 5 minutes and the weather will change. We need the Lady Airedales to get this ball down the court, get something going before they fall behind too far. They got behind really quick against Van Buren and never able to catch up. It was down by as much as 35-6 in that game on Tuesday night. Van Buren, or I should say Harrison, with the full court pressure. And the Lady Airedales get it across midcourt. Going to be stolen away. So Alma not even able to get a shot up as yet. And the jump ball is going to keep it with the Lady Airedales. They have not even attempted a shot. Checking in for the first time for the Airedales, Briella Hughes is in the game, number four. Kylie Poole's got it. You get it down low to Gramlich. Turn, spins, no good, and the rebound, Harrison. I think she was a little bit more open than she maybe thought. Harrison gets a feed down low. It's taken away and then lost out of bounds. Gramlich could not hang on to it. It's going to stay with Harrison. Big crowd on Tuesday night. Not quite the crowd yet tonight. Here's a shot for Harrison. It's no good, and the rebound, Lady Airedales have it. Gramlich going to fire up a three. It's good. Alma's on the board down 8-3. So each team comes out firing from deep. A couple of trays for Harrison, one for Alma. Under 5 minutes left here in the first quarter. It's 8-3. The Goblins have the lead. Massengale's got it. Passes back over. Here's a drive in the lane, almost a travel. Got 8 seconds on the shot clock. Now they drive it all the way and scoop it up and score. And the basket by Jones. Lila Jones is on the board. That's her first bucket tonight. That'll make it a 10-3 advantage and fast break, but the bad pass stolen away by Harrison. Here comes Barger across the midcourt. Here's a drive up inside, no good, and the rebound, Gramlich. 4 minutes left here in the first quarter, a 10-3 game, Harrison on top. Three-point shot from McCart, good. Back-to-back three-point shots for the Lady Airedales, and they trail it four by four, it's 10-6. So both teams, a couple of three-point shots apiece, and Harrison on top by a four. Here's a drive in the lane, no good, block out, and a rebound, the Lady Airedales have it. And the ball is tipped out of bounds, going to stay with Alma. 3:26 to play here in the first quarter of play, and checking in for the first time will be Benson. Eliza Benson checks in for the Lady Airedales, number 30, sophomore. .3:15 left here in the first quarter of play, and the Lady Airedales trying to trim the lead. Here's a three-point shot for Gramlich. It's in and out, no good, and the rebound, Harrison. Vincent almost got to it, not quite enough. Here come the Lady Goblins. They spin it outside, three-point shots up and no good, and the rebound, Alma. Taken away by McKinley McCart. Harrison comes in with a record on the season, 9 and 11. And 3-3 in the conference play. They got a game to make up with Greenwood. Here's another three for Alma. That one's no good. The long rebound taken down by the Lady Airedales. They catch a break on that long rebound. 2:30 left here in the first quarter of play, a 10-6 advantage. And Alma, errant pass, and going to be a foul in the backcourt. That's going to be against the Lady Airedales. That's going to be on Kylie Poole. Nope, that's on Benson. 2:23 left, and second foul here in the first quarter on the Lady Airedales. It's going to be Harrison basketball in the backcourt. Goblins moving around. They got 15 on the shot clock, and they almost lost it. And it's going to be a Lady Airedale basketball, I think. No foul, just going to be out of bounds. It's going to be on the ball with 2 minutes exactly to play in the first quarter. 10-6, Harrison on top by four. It's camo night. Student body dressed in their camo. And that's going to be a turnover. I think, well, maybe not. Poole gets the inbounds pass, and here come the Lady Airedales. Gramlich's got it, gets it to McKinley McCart across midcourt. Gets it over to Jordan Gramlich, the team's leading scorer coming into tonight's game. Gramlich going to drive, puts up a shot, up and in. Gramlich has got five, and the Lady Airedales, after being down 8-0, have scored the eight of the last 10 points and cut it to two. It's 10-8. Driving the lane, Harrison up and in. They get the basket to go down. That's Barger, sophomore, 5'10". Haven Welch will check in for the first time for the Lady Airedales. 1:20 left here in the first quarter. It's a 10-8 or 12-8 game. Harrison on top. Lady Airedales have it. Gramlich going to drive all the way. Contact, draws a foul, and she'll shoot two. That's Jaden on the drive. A minute left here in the first quarter of play, and Jaden Gramlich will stop the clock with a minute left and shoot two foul shots. That's the first free throws here tonight. At the friendly bounce, and Alma cuts it to 3, 12-9. One more to come. Got them both. So Jaden's got her first points here this evening, and the Airedales, with that, have cut it down to a 12-10 game. Loose ball picked up by the Goblins. 45 seconds left to get a pass inside and a reach-in foul called against the Lady Airedales. That's the second foul called against Eliza Benson. She'll check out. Rayla Hughes will check back in. So the Lady Airedales have cut it to 2, 12-10. Harrison's got the inbounds. A long three-point shot's in and out, and Haven Welch has a rebound. 40 seconds left here in the first quarter, and the shot clock, you're about 8 seconds differential. Alma's got it. Alma gets it down to Haven. Haven spins, lost it, goes off the backboard, but she is fouled. 27.2 left, and she'll shoot two foul shots. Got the band here tonight, and got the cheerleaders. Camo night. Haven Welch, foul shot's good. Kind of funny, you know, you're talking about basketball and playing at home, and these home dates are running out. You run out of football home dates, and after tonight, just three more home games for the gold and the green and gold. Haven Welch got them both, and we are tied up. So Alma's 4-for-4 from the charity stripe to start this game, and we're tied at 12. So a great finish to the first quarter for the Lady Airedales, who trailed early 8-0. No standings. That 1-6 record's really tough because the Lady Airedales, there's a shot that's no good, and the rebound, Lady Airedales have it back. Got all kind of contact down there in the backcourt. Finally, they call a foul on Harrison. Alma could easily be 3-4, shoulda, woulda, coulda. They lost a tough game at home against Mountain Home and earlier lost a game, had one get away against Greenbrier. That's the game where the Panthers shot like 18 free throws in the last 5 minutes of the game. 12-12 with 4 seconds left, and Alma's got to hurry to get a shot off. Haven Welch puts it up, it goes, no good. That'll do it. At the end of one quarter of play, we're tied up at 12. Let's take timeout. This is the finale of a three-game homestand for the girls and the guys. Alma's going to be on the highway up the mountain on Tuesday. They'll be in Siloam Springs to take on the Panthers. Now Alma back home a week from tonight. Russellville will be in town. So we got the Cyclones coming in next Friday night. And then it gets tough. You got Russellville next Friday night, got Harrison tonight, then you got Van Buren on the 13th. That's going to be a tough one again. So some big, big games on the way for the Airedales. Second quarter underway to travel. Harrison's Brooklyn Mitchell had it, and then not sure where to go with it, turns it over. 7:50 left here in the first half, 12-12. The Lady Airedales on a 12-4 run have tied this game up. Haven Welch in the ballgame starting the second quarter. Shot clock at 10. Haven Welch has it outside. They got to get something going here. McCart's thinking about it. Gets it down to Welch. Turn. Scoop. Scores. Haven Welch has 4. Alma by 2. 14-12. Here come the Goblins. Mitchell all the way, lays it up and in. Nice play by Brooklyn Mitchell. Good-looking sophomore player, 5'8". Pretty good move. We're tied up again at 14. First time the Lady Airedales have had the lead since last Friday night's game with Mountain Home. They had just never had a chance against Van Buren on Tuesday night. Haven Welch down low, kicks it outside to Hughes. Briella Hughes outside. Here's a three-point shot for Alma. It's no good. The rebound is tracked down by the Lady Goblins. Here comes Harrison across midcourt. 14-14 game. Harrison came out and hit 2 threes. Here's a little 18-footer. It's no good. And the rebound, Haven Welch has 3 of those. And Lady Airedales have it back. They knocked down those first 2 threes. You start thinking, oh, my gosh, here we go again. But since then, no luck from beyond the arc. Jordan Gramlich got it, drives inside, kicks it outside. Here is a three-point shot, no good, and the rebound tapped out by Welch, saved by the Lady Airedales. That's one of those stats. Technically, I think the rebound goes to McCart, but really, it ought to go to Welch. She's the one that got the hand on it. Here's Gramlich, good defense from Harrison. Gramlich up, no good, and the rebound, Goblins. And Harrison gets a feed down low. They missed it. Rebounded by the Goblins. They kick it back outside. Three-point shot from Brooklyn Mitchell's good. And the Lady Goblins go back in front by 3 at 17-14. Again, Harrison defeated Alma the first time they played 61-30. They won it by 31 points. But tonight, better start for the Lady Airedales, who hanging in there, down by just 3 points as we hit the 5-minute mark of the first half. Gramlich outside, going to be a foul called against the Goblins. That's the first team foul here in the second quarter of play. And that is the second foul called on Harrison's Bryn Bonds, sophomore. They got some young players. Inbounds comes to the Lady Airedales. And a jump shot is no good, and the rebound, Goblins. Long pass down the court. Here's Brooklyn Mitchell all the way up. No good, but she is fouled, and she'll shoot 2. It's not Mitchell, by the way. That was on Bryn Bonds. First free throw on the way. It's no good. So Harrison gets one more. 4 minutes and 45 seconds to play in the first half. Harrison by 3. Missed them both. Rebounded by Gramlich. That's Jordan. Or it's Jaden. Two Jordan. They're twins, and the only way sometimes to tell them apart is a number, and unfortunately both have threes. One's 23, the other's 33. Jordan's 33. Good feed down low to Jordan. Turned around, spins. No good. And the Goblins have the rebound. Somebody else is going to have to pick it up because she's getting 2 and 3 players on her every time she gets it. Should have a pretty good boys game after this one. Here's a drive for Harrison. No good. And the rebound is lost out of bounds. Goes to Alma. Those boys standings, the Airedales 7-0. Harrison 4-3. As we start the second round of conference play. And Alma's got the advantage with 4 of the last 7 games will be here. Starting with this game tonight, they've got Russellville here. They've got Greenwood. Got Greenbrier as well. Here's a drive inside and a foul called against the Goblins. So second team foul called on Harrison. They're going to call that a shooting foul. So Jordan Gramlich going to be at the free throw line to attempt some foul shots here. First one is on the way, and it is good. Alma's 5 for 5 from the free throw line. Haven Welch back in the game. Haven's got 4 points. Grimlick's second foul shot is good again. So Alma 6 for 6 to start this game from the line. That's a good sign. They trail it by 1, 17 to 16. Three-point shot for the Goblins off the mark. No good. The rebound, Harrison tracks it down. They're going to launch another three. It's up and good. Boy, second chance, three-point baskets, and that's a big one right there made by Brooklyn Mitchell. And Mitchell's got herself 8 points. 20-16, Goblins back in front by 4. Well, those 50-50 balls will get you. 3 minutes, about 3 minutes left here in the first quarter of play. Here's a three-point shot for Alma. It's no good. Tapped out by Welch, and it goes back over to Harrison. So under 3 minutes left, Goblins have the ball. They trail it by 4, 20-16. Alma gave up 42 first-half points when they played at Harrison. Here's a shot that's no good, but a foul. It's going to be a blockout foul called against the Lady Airedales. I think that's on Grimlick. That's the first foul called against Jordan. Here's a shot, no good, and a rebound. Harrison again, another offensive rebound. That first time they played, it was 42-17 at halftime. Here's a drive up and in. Mitchell's got 10. And the Goblins back in front by 6 here tonight, 22-16. Here's a shot, no good, but a foul call. Kylie Poole going to shoot some foul shots. Kylie's free throw is no good. She'll get one more. Got three team fouls against Harrison here in this second quarter, and Kylie Poole got that one. So one out of two, and it's 22-17. So from 42-17 to 22-17, much better start here for Alma tonight against the Lady Goblins. Goblins have it in a reach-in foul call. That's an offensive foul. That's a push-off on the Lady Goblins. That's a fourth foul called against Harrison, so Alma's got it back. Foul called against Barger. That's her first foul. 22-17, Alma. Three-point shot top of the circle is no good, and the rebound, Harrison. They kick it outside. They travel, no call. They make a shot, only a two. They stepped inside the three-point line. 24-17, so Harrison back in front. They led it by as much as 8. Alma came back and actually took a 14-12 lead, but now the Goblins have gone back in front by 7 points, and we got all kind of contact in there. And a reach-in foul called, I think, against Harrison. Let's check the official. Yep. It's going to be on the Goblins. That's her fifth team foul here in the second quarter. So it's a free throws bonus for the Lady Airedales. Two foul shots coming for Jordan Grimlick with the minute 34 left here in the first half. Big shots here for the Airedales. 6 out of 8 from the line tonight. First one's up and good. Riley Hughes back in. She'll replace Haven Welch. Grimlick one more. That one's is in and out, no good. So 7 out of 10, 70% from the foul line for the Lady Airedales, and they find themselves down by 6 points, 24-18 with a minute 25 left in the first half. Here's Mitchell. Kicks it outside. Three-point shot short. Rebounded by the Lady Airedales. Band's having a lot of fun tonight. Gramlich drives all the way. Lays it up and missed it. Had a strong move. Just didn't drop in. Harrison kicks it down low, and the ball is taken away by the Lady Airedales. Now we get a jump ball. Or do we? Maybe a foul. I do have a foul. Foul called against Harrison. So Kylie Poole goes back to the charity stripe here with 56 seconds to play in the first half. That's a 16 foul here in the second quarter against Harrison. Just two against Alma. That's McKinley McCart at the line. Missed the first one. She'll get one more. That was 7 for 11. They started off 6 for 6, but they've missed 4 of the last 5, and that one rolls in. So Alma trails it 24 to 19 with 56.8 seconds to play in the first half. Goblins get a feed down low. It's tipped out of bounds. It should be Harrison. Now they're going to give it to Alma. Jaden Humphrey going to check in for the Lady Airedales. First time she's been in here tonight. Jaden is a sophomore. Kylie Poole dishes outside to Humphrey. Back over it goes to Briella Hughes. Humphrey beyond the three-point line. Long pass across the way, and Alma running some clock here. 25 seconds at 15 on the shot clock. Humphrey. Back over to Gramlich, going to launch a three. It's good! Big shot from Jaden. Alma trails by two. 10 seconds left here at halftime. And we got a foul called against Alma. 7 seconds to play. That's not a bad foul. That's the third team foul. No foul shots yet for the Goblins. Brooklyn Mitchell is on her way. She's already got 10 points. So Harrison's got it. 5 seconds left. Here we go. Here's a long three-point shot. It's off the back of the backboard and goes in. So the Goblins lead Alma at halftime, 27-22. And the Lady Airedales, a strong finish that first half. But they trail it by five at the break, 27-22. Let's take timeout.
In 1886, aluminum was developed. The first Coca-Cola was sold. The Statue of Liberty was dedicated. And Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County opened for business. We say, they don't make things like they used to. And maybe that's true. But for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank for all of Crawford County.
Crabtree RV Center, leading the River Valley in sales and service for over 70 years. Founded in 1950, Crabtree RV Center has grown into one of the largest family-owned and operated RV dealerships in Northwest Arkansas. Located on 17 acres, including a 26,000 square foot indoor showroom, Crabtree RV Center has everything you need, all in one convenient location. Crabtree RV Center in Alma, Arkansas, making your family's dreams come true.
You know, we may not all agree on everything, but when we walk through these doors, we can have one thing in common, and that's Jesus. With all the stuff going on in the world, all the good, all the bad, this church has been something constant for me and my family four generations back. and something that can stay constant for my kids going forward. They're still the same church, and they're still the same people that I can still depend on and go to when I need something.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Omega Car and Truck Accessories would like to invite you to come by and take a tour of our new retail showroom behind Brahms in Alma. Interactive working displays and a fully stocked warehouse allow you to pick out today's hottest accessories and get them installed fast. Wheels and tires, audio video, LED lighting, steps, lift kits, bed liners, custom interiors, towing, computer cut window tinting, Omega does it all. And with certified technicians, we guarantee the job will be done right. If customer service and value are important to you, choose Omega Car and Truck Accessories.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project become reality.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
Hey. I'm Brent.
I'm Dale. But you have to call me Dragon.
Well, then you have to call me Nightwing.
All right, Nightwing. Let's play a little game. On count of three, I want you to say your favorite travel story. Don't even think about it. Just say it, all right? One, two, three.
Larkness! What's your favorite deli item? Chicken strips!
We've become best friends?
Yeah.
All right.
Let's go to work. Yeah! All right. Now that we're finally here, what's your favorite homemade jelly or jam? Peach jam! Me too.
Yeah.
Wow. Look at all the amazing honeys and jams and all these other goodies.
Wow. Excuse me, ma'am. That looks delicious. Oh, burger, that's my burger. They're really good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Look at the wide variety it gets.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Larkmans! Yeah!
Mo. Ça tue, ça blesse, ça flingue. Hey, hey, hey. Mo. Gazo. Ça tue, ça blesse, ça flingue. Aïe, 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 grip, mou. Gazo, aïe, aïe, aïe. Grip, clic, mou.
Lumber One is a locally owned lumber yard located in Van Buren, Arkansas, down on Industrial Park Road. We've been in business since 2002, and our vision is to provide quality building materials to the professional builder and to the do-it-yourselfer at competitive prices. Lumber One offers a full line of lumber, unfinished and finished plywood, engineered wood, cedar products, and LP smart siding and trim, along with access to James Hardy siding and other pre-finished siding. We also carry roofing, insulation materials, drywall, and wood sidings like shiplap siding, cedar lap and gap, and car siding. Our full-line door shop can handle all your door, window, and trim needs. We offer several different exterior door and glass options from Therma-True, MAI Doors, and Western Reflections. We also stock several different interior door styles from Gelled Wen, with access to their entire interior door line and others. We have a full-time estimator on staff who can do blueprint takeoffs and estimated material list for whatever project you have. He can work with contractors or homeowners to help you get your project started and answer any questions you may have. You'll also have access to an outside sales representative that will be there throughout the building process from start to finish. Our mission is to provide service at a level that differentiates us as the best in the marketplace. Lumber One, where service still matters.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs. On-site insurance filing and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
Kevin Taylor and Airwaves Media. It's halftime here in the arena. And the Lady Airedales at halftime trail the Lady Goblins 27-22. And Alma trying to fight back. They were down 8-0 early and finished off very strong first half. Alma on a 22-19 run to close it out, but they were down early 8-0. And they came back strong. Some good inside play and some good outside play as well from the Lady Airedales. And the Lady Airedales is going to try to mount the comeback in that third quarter of play. Standings again in the girls. Mountain Home was undefeated. They barely got a win out of here on Friday night, last Friday night, and they got pounded on Tuesday night. I think Russellville got them by 29 points. So Russellville, Mountain Home are 6-1. Greenwood still has a game to make up with Harrison. They're 5-1. Harrison 3-3. Van Buren 3-4. Greenbrier's 3-4. And the Lady Airedales 1-6, Asylum Springs 0-7. Again, kind of tough for the Lady Airedales because two of those losses, they lost a couple of games to the, they lost, hey, it's Lewis Alexander, how you doing? Alma lost a couple of tough games to 9 points at Greenbrier, and they lost at home against Mountain Home. So, hey, the Alma junior boys have a chance to make some history on Monday night. And a win against Farmington, which will not be easy, would give the Airedales and Coach Eddie Corder just his second, well, his third overall conference championship in all those years of junior high coaching. Be the second in the last 4 years, so that's a big deal. That's coming up on Monday as Alma plays at Farmington. Alma's undefeated 8-0. Van Buren's lost twice. They're 6-2, and the Cardinals are 5-3. So a win again by the Airedales would give them a outright conference championship. It's been a fun team to watch, and I've seen those kids grow up, and really it's a team with a couple of really, really good players and a bunch of really good role players. No superstars on the team. Everybody kind of does their role, and some guys dish it, some guys rebound it, some guys occasionally hit a three, but it's a really good balanced team. They like each other. Makes a big difference. Kind of like this senior high team. But yep, they are 19-2 in a great season for Coach Eddie Corder, and let's see how it goes Monday night at Farmington. And congrats again to Athletic Director Doug Lockridge. 7 years the football coach here, and Coach Locke, if you did not hear, named the head football coach at Asylum Springs that became official last night. And he's got some work to do. He knows it. Panthers have lost 27 straight games, and they're 1-29 in their last 30. But that's a good challenge, and there's still plenty in the tank, you'd got to believe, for Coach Lockridge. Won a bunch of games, 68-9 in his run at Charleston. Came to Alma, went 48-36. Almost made the finals in 2013. Had that tough, brutal loss in the semifinals out here against Batesville. But they got a chance to get things turned around. And, of course, wouldn't you know it, Alma, Asylum Springs do play the next 2 years. So that'll happen next couple times, at least the next 2 years. They're not in the same conference, but they did sign up to play non-conference again. So that'll happen, I believe it's week two this coming season, and it'll be week two in 2025 as well. So good luck to Coach Locke and the Asylum Springs Panthers. Plus, you get to spend every day with Jeff Williams. I mean, that's a win-win right there. So the Lady Airedales are back on the floor. 27-22. Jeff Williams, the athletic director at Solemn Springs, former Southside coach. And been a crazy, surreal day. Started the day at school. Actually saw some baseball this afternoon. Got to watch LT throw. A little college baseball at Poto, and then made it back here for the basketball game tonight. So a lot of excitement. And we have coffee. Coach Locke's not here to make the coffee. I guess Coach Powell must have made it because it's good. It's solid. So we have coffee. That's good. Second half about to start. Alma down by five, and they're going to have the first possession. Callie Poole, McKinley McCart, Jaden, and Jordan Gramlich out there. Also, Briella Hughes gets the start here in the second half. No Demaya Parker here tonight with the dance team. Good defense. They're going to pass it off. 10 seconds on the shot clock, so they got to get something going. Shot clock down to five. And they're going to have to hoist it up. 3 seconds left. Long three-point shot's going to be way short. Just not a very good offensive set at all. And a nice job by the Goblins on defense. Allen never got a shot off in time. And Harrison's going to have the first possession here of this third quarter. Up five, 27-22. Goblins moving it around. Again, Harrison beat Alma. There's a three-point shot, and that's good. That's Brooklyn Mitchell. She's got 13, and that'll make it 16, my bad. That'll make it an eight-point game, so that matches the 8-0 start they had to start the game. It's 30-22. Here's a drive for the Airedales. Up, no good. And the rebound, Harrison. Lady Airedale, junior high team, they're currently sitting there with a couple of losses. They've got a chance to get to the region tournament. That'll be at Greenwood. Here's a shot, no good. Gramlich's got the rebound. And Coach Rushing's team, here's a shot, up, no good. They got a chance to get back into it as well. They got Farmington on Monday at home. And then Alma's going to finish out next Thursday in junior high with Van Buren. The boys will be at Crabtree, and the girls are going to be at Van Buren. Shot's no good, and the rebound, Gramlich has it. Haley Ostrander's junior team playing well. They had a nice game. There's a shot, no good, a lot of contact, no foul. Her team, her seventh graders, lost to Farmington by three. That's a good sign. Here's a three-point shot for Harrison, no good. Good blockout from Gramlich. Here comes Alma, 5:40 left here in this third quarter. Good feed down low to Jaden, up and in for two. Beautiful pass from McKinley McCart. 30-24, Goblins have it by six. They've got it back. Harrison led at halftime by five, 27-22. That's a travel. Nope, going to call the offensive moving screen. That's the second time they've got them for that. That's a second team foul. Now check that. First team foul here in the second half. That's the second time it happened to the same player. That's on Barger. That's her third overall. She's got 4 points. Kenley McCart's got it. Five minutes left here in this third quarter of play, and Alma trails it by 6 points. Here's Gramlich up, scoops it in, no good, and the rebound, Harrison. Under 5 minutes left here in the third. Here come the Goblins. Here's a wide open three up, no good, and the rebound. Harrison's got the rebound. Had white jerseys everywhere, but Harrison came away with the board. Massengale missed that three, and Harrison able to track the rebound down. This is Mitchell, 16 points on the night. Shot clock at 12. Game clock at 4. minutes and 18 seconds. Here's a three-point shot. It's no good, and a rebound, Alma. Airedales trailing by 6 points. Go back to the end of the first half, and Mitchell banked that three. Well, that was a huge shot. Instead of being down at halftime by just two, Alma trailed at halftime by five. Here's a feed on the baseline. Shot is up and good. Goblins go back in front by 8, 32-24. Yeah, we're back on the road Tuesday night at Silent Springs, and then the Airedales return home for the Cyclones. Russellville will be in town next Friday night. Three-point shot is an air ball, no good, and the Goblins get it back. Been really impressed. A well-coached team, Russellville Lady Cyclones. LaShonda Johnson spent some time, long time, assistant coach down at Conway. And she's got that program going. They've also got a lot of seniors on that team. Cyclones come into play tonight as they will take on Greenwood. That's a huge game in the 5A West for the girls. Greenwood won the first matchup by one in overtime. Here's a drive fin, a block. Haven Welch back in the game, picks up the block, and almost got it back, down by eight. Here's Gramlich on the baseline, spins, puts it up, draws a foul. She'll shoot two. That's the second team foul called against Harrison. That's the third foul called against number 30, Bryn Bonds, 5'8" sophomore. Gramlich's foul shot short. She'll get one more. 2:51 to play, so a slow start to the second half for the Lady Airedales. Free throws up, and that one's good. Alma trails it by seven. Rayla Hughes back in the game for the Lady Airedales. Eliza Benson also re-enters the game for Alma. 2 minutes and 45 seconds to play in the third quarter. It's a 32-25 game. Goblins have it back. They shoot it inside, and it's picked up by Benson. .220 left here in the third quarter. Three-point shots on the way. Get in there. It's no good. And rebound, Benson. Good job by Eliza Benson to track that thing down. And the Airedale's going to reset the offense. Haven Welch going to be called for a double dribble. Goes back over to Harrison. So 2 minutes and 5 seconds to play. Just 3 points here in the second half for the Lady Airedales, who find themselves down. They were down at halftime 27-22. They trail it right now 32-25 with a minute 55 left. Shot at the top of the free throw line's up and good. It's Massengale. She's got 10 points. So Massengale and Mitchell have combined for 26. That's the big duo right there. And the bad news for everybody in the conference is, Massengale's a senior. Mitchell's a sophomore. Alma trails by nine. That's her biggest deficit tonight. Here's a shot, no good. And tipped around. Who's got it? Going to be a scramble for it. Jump ball. It's going to go back to Harrison. So Jordan Gramlich's going to have to re-enter for the Lady Airedales. Just having a hard time getting any kind of offensive flow. Haven Welch will check out. 1:26 to play in the third quarter. It's a 34-25 game. Goblins have the lead and the basketball. Here's the drive. Harrison, they traveled. So the Lady Airedales get it back. A minute seven left. Alma needs a little bit of a run here to get back in this thing. They trail at 34-25. Here's a drive inside. Get in there. It counts. Count the basket and a foul. So Jordan Gramlich gets it to drop in. That's 12 points for Jordan here tonight. And a chance for a three-point play. Alma down 7. This right here would cut it to 6. She got it. 13 points for Jordan. And Alma trails by 6, 34 to 28. Three-point shots on the way for Harrison. It's no good. Blocked out. And the Lady Airedales have it. That's McKinley McCart's contact. Hangs on to it. Nearly went back and forth across the line. But they let the Airedales keep it. Here's Gramlich again. Drives inside. Puts it up and missed it. Rebound Goblins. So 21 seconds left. That would have been huge right there. Alma down by 6. They trailed by 5 after 3 quarters of play. Shot clock is off. Harrison's going to play for the last shot. 10 seconds on the clock. And Harrison turns it over, so the Airedales get it back at midcourt with 2.7. See if they can get somebody to get a shot off here. So they're going to get the inbounds pass. 2.7 left, and it's going to be Kylie Poole with the inbounds pass to somebody, to McCart. And here we go, McKinley puts up a heave. It's going to be short, and that'll do it. At the end of 3 quarters of play, it's Harrison 34, now with 26. We'll be right back. Well, the fourth quarter on the way. Kevin Taylor, Airwaves Media, back in the arena. Alma down by 6 points. Big 3-point. Oh, an errant pass inside. Alma's going to hang on to it somehow. Here's Gramlich. Turns around, lays it up and in. Well, they caught a break on that one. And Alma cuts it down to, that's Jaden with 8 points now. Alma trails it by 4. It's 34-30 with 7:35 left here in this ballgame. Good spin move inside, no good. The rebound, Alma. McKinley McCart passes outside to Jordan Gramlich. .7:15 to play in this game. Gramlich going to drive in, spins, puts it up, missed it. And the rebound, Gramlich, up, up, and in. Alma cuts it to 2. Jaden's got 10, so 13 for Jordan, 10 for Jaden. It's a 2-point game. 34-32. 6:50 left here in this game. 3-point shot for Harrison's no good, and the rebound, good block out. McKinley McCart's got it. Here come the Lady Airedales. Alma down by as much as 9, but they've cut it to 2. 7 straight points for the Lady Airedales. Shots up for Alma. It's no good. And crashing the boards. Jump ball, but it's going to go back to Harrison. So that's good effort from Jaden. And at least the next time you have one of those, it'll be Alma with the arrow. So the arrow goes back to the Airedales, but they are back on defense, down by 2. Fire. 16 points from Brooklyn Mitchell. There's a shot missed outside from Massengale, and the Airedales have another rebound. Kylie Poole thinking about it. Kylie's got 1 point here tonight. 2 point game. Gramlich drives in, draws the contact, and she'll shoot two. A chance to knot this thing up. We got a timeout, 30-second timeout for Harrison coach Stacy Quatt. So what's coming up again for the Lady Airedales? Tuesday night, Alma's going to be on the road at Salem Springs. A week from tonight, back home to play Russellville. And then a huge rematch on the 13th. That'll be over at Van Buren. Then Alma's got two more home games right after that. Greenwood and Greenbrier. And then the finale, they'll be on the road at Mountain Home. So we'll see how it shakes out. It's one game at a time. Airedales obviously off to a 7-0 start, the boys are. Two-game lead coming into play tonight. The matchups again, as we start round two, Greenbrier has got Van Buren. That's over at Greenbrier. Mountain Home's got Salem Springs, and Greenwood plays Russellville. That's the way the second half of the conference shapes up, kicks off. So Gramlich, 13 points at the line to shoot two with 5:46 to play in the game. Jordan's foul shot's on the way. It is good. 1 point game, 34-33. Alma's led just one time. They led by two early, 14-12 in the first half. That's the only lead they've had in this game. Got them both. We're tied up at 34. That's the first time we've been tied since it was 14-14, so 5:40 left to play, and the Goblins have it back. Yeah, Travel. Give it back to the Lady Airedales, you betcha. Travel called on Lila Jones, 5'6 junior, and the Lady Airedales will have it back. Harrison's going to put some pressure in the backcourt. Team fouls here in this fourth quarter. Just one foul called on each, or nope, one foul called against Harrison, none against Alma. Timeouts, full a backcourt violation. That's kind of tough because looked like she got there in time, but they call it nonetheless. Each team has four timeouts remaining and 5:23 left to play here in the game, and the Goblins have it back tied up at 34. So great effort tonight from Chanley Bottoms, and a steal for the, oh, the Goblins hang on to it. Almost had a jump ball and a foul called against Alma. Boy, Massengale strong. Hanging on to that ball. 5:09 left to play. And the inbounds comes to Harrison. And poked away. This time it is stolen away. And the Lady Airedales, that's Briella Hughes. Hughes gives it off to McKinley McCart. They get it down to Gramlich, and Gramlich, oh, it's going to be an offensive foul. So Gramlich's third foul, trying to get position, and is called for the charge. Official right there on it, and Harrison's got it back. Under 5 minutes left to play in the game, tied up at 34. So 4:45 to play, and Harrison gets a feed on the block to kick it outside. Kind of seems like the Lady Goblins had that lead, and they nearly threw it away. Now they get an easy layup. So first time they've scored in a little bit. They were up by nine, and Alma had scored the last 9 points, but now the Goblins finally snapped the streak and go back in front. It seemed to me like they just got a little bit tight. When you play not to lose, that's going to hurt you. But the Goblins do have the lead again, 36-34. And going to be a foul called against Harrison. And so the Goblins pick up their second team foul. That's two team fouls apiece on each team. 4 minutes and 11 seconds to play, and Lady Airedale's down two. Inbounds comes to Gramlich. Kicks it outside to the other Gramlich. That's Jordan, 33. Right at 4 minutes left to play. Offensive foul. Moving screen. That's three fouls against the Lady Airedales. So the Lady Airedales now find themselves down by two. With 4 minutes left, Goblins have the ball back, and Chan Lee Bottoms wants a timeout. So 30-second timeout. It's going to be Harrison basketball when play resumes with 4 minutes to play, and the Goblins up by two, 36-34. Yeah, the Lady Airedales finished that first round of conference play 1-6, and gosh, lost a couple of tough games in there. They lost that game at Greenbrier. That's the one that really hurts because they were up four. Seemed like they had about seven or eight chances to extend the lead in that third quarter. Just never could. And Greenbrier, give them credit, they came back and won it by nine. And then Alma had a chance to beat Mountain Home, who was number one in the state at the time, and just could not finish it off. Lost by five at home last Friday night. So the Goblins have it. Clock runs under 4 minutes left to play, and Harrison up by two, 36-34. Massengale drives inside in trouble. She traveled. Yes, sirree. Alma's got it back. So the Goblins will apply some pressure in the backcourt. Massengale too far underneath the basket. Just had nowhere to go. Kylie Poole's got it down to Hughes. Hughes covered up, double teamed. Going to drive in, kicks it out. It's tipped, saved by the Lady Airedales. Kylie Poole to Jordan Gramlich, top of the circle. Gramlich is fouled. And that's going to be the third foul called against Harrison. That is the third foul also called against Brooklyn. Nope, that's on Massengale. Annabelle Massengale, the senior guard, picks up her third foul. So each team has fouled three times here in the fourth quarter. Alma's ball out of bounds. McKinley McCart down to Gramlich. Spins, turns, shoots, missed it. Did not get the favorable home bounce that time, and the Goblins have it back. .310 left to play here in this game. This would be a huge win. Just something to build on for Coach Bottoms in this program. Mitchell's got it and drives over a player. Going to shoot two foul shots. Kylie Poole got the raw end of that deal. That's her fourth foul as well. And at the charity stripe, Brooklyn Mitchell, a chance to extend the lead to four. Mitchell's free throw is good. She'll get one more. So 17 points for Brooklyn. 2:57 left to play in the game. 37-34, and the next one's up and good. So got them both. So Alma's got a little work to do. Down four with 2:55 left to play. And you get it across midcourt. Almost there they are across midcourt. Need to score on this possession. Gramlich kicks it outside. Three-point shot's on the way. It's no good. And rebound to Alma. Gramlich off the glass. No good. Got a rebound. Foul. Puts it up. Count the basket. And a foul shot coming up. Fourth foul called against Massengale. Haven Welch will check in for the Lady Airedales. Gramlich's got 17. A chance to get 18. Free throw is on the way, and it is good. Missed it. Rebound goes out of bounds. Alma's going to save it. Alma down two. Haven Welch going to launch a three. It's no good. And the rebound, chase down. Who's got it? Goes off of Harrison. Is going to stay with Alma. Mercy me. 2:31 left to play, and Alma's got it. Out of bounds, down two, 38-36. Haven Welch had 4 points early in the first half. 17 for Jordan Gramlich. Kylie Poole gets the inbounds pass. It comes out to McCart. McKinley's got four. Oh, a travel. No, we got an offensive foul. Got a moving screen. They love that. That's the fourth or fifth time they've called that on each team. Both teams have been guilty of that tonight. So Harrison gets it back with 2:27 left, up two. And that's five fouls on Alma, four on Harrison. So from here on out, both teams are going to be in the foul in the bonus. Harrison running some clock, closing in on 2 minutes left to play. 38-36, Goblins by two. Here's a shot, it's on the way, it's no good. The rebound, Alma's got it. Kylie Poole gets that rebound. And a foul called against Harrison. Kylie Poole with a minute 49 left. Going to have a chance to tie this game. That's a fourth foul called against Lila Jones. I love it when rosters have the numbers are all out of order. So I got to track down 32. There's a 13 in there. There's a 4. Anyway, so a timeout, full timeout. Harrison by two. Let's take a timeout with you. We'll be right back.
In 1886, aluminum was developed. The first Coca-Cola was sold. The Statue of Liberty was dedicated. And Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County opened for business. We say, they don't make things like they used to. And maybe that's true. But for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank for all of Crawford County.
Well, it's tough and tight. It's always a good time for a good old hot dog, isn't it? You betcha. Minute 49 left to play. And the Airedales are going to be shooting foul shots after this timeout. 38-36, Harrison by two. Again, the Goblins beat Alma the last time they played, 61-30. So much different effort tonight defensively for the Lady Airedales, who have a chance to tie this game up with a minute 49 left to play. Kylie Poole, one out of two from the line tonight. Free throws up, and that one's no good, so she'll get one more. Alma started strong 6-for-6, but they've struggled since. Kylie just 1-for-3, a chance to cut it to one here, and the free throw's up, and that one's good. One-point game, 38-37. Goblins have it. Minute 45 left to play. Brooklyn Mitchell calls out the offense. Shot clock down to 15. They kick it outside. Mitchell's got it. 1:25 left. Mitchell, strong move up and count it, and a foul. Big shot from Mitchell. 20 points for Brooklyn Mitchell. Minute 23 left. That'll make it a 3-point lead for Harrison. So the Lady Airedales on the brink of being down four with not much time left. And with 23 to play, and the free throw is in and out, no good. They missed it. You catch a break on that missed foul shot. Now Alma trails by three with a minute 15 to play. Gramlich kicks it outside. McCart going to launch a three. Get in there. Nope. Rebound Harrison. And a foul called against Briella Hughes going back the other way. And free throws are coming for Bryn Bonds, sophomore, with a minute 8 left. Or nope. Whose ball? I guess it's Harrison's ball. I thought the foul shows 5 for, okay. Inbounds comes to Harrison. I'm not sure what happened. Might have been out of bounds. Nonetheless, Harrison's got it. A minute left to play. Goblins by 3. Clock at 54 seconds and counting. 19 on the shot clock. Brooklyn Mitchell's got it. 40-37. Harrison by 3 with 45 seconds left. Here's an open lane. Going to be a block called against Alma. And the Goblins are going to shoot two foul shots with 42 seconds left. And the Lady Airedales just have a hard time catching a break at home. Brooklyn Mitchell with 20 points will be shooting the free throws. It's good. 41-37 with 42.2 seconds left. Good effort tonight, but the Lady Airedales down four, and now they're down five. So Harrison's going to back off a little bit. 40 seconds left. They got to hurry. Almost got to score twice. And somewhere in there going to stop. 34 seconds to play. 22 points for Brooklyn Mitchell. Kylie Poole, they got to shoot threes. They got to hurry. Here's a three-point shot from McCart. It's no good. And the rebound. Alma's got it back. Jordan Gramlich going to launch a three. It's no good. And the Goblins have the rebound. That may do it. 22 seconds left. Harrison's going to have a run out. It's going to be a layup. And the Goblins are going to win the game. 44-37 with 5 seconds left, and that'll do it. So Harrison tonight comes in here and comes away with the win. Tough one. Yeah, I'm a battle, but they fall tonight at home 44-37. Brooklyn Mitchell had 22 points to lead the way for Harrison, 17 for Jordan Gramlich. Alma drops to 1-7 in the 5A West. So a big matchup with the boys is coming up. But first, let's take timeout.
Shoot up pescatarian, but he eat up all the beef. 21. You gave me yours to kiss, but want the all of me. Yeah. I stand on business, dot my I's and cross my T's. All I got is these little pictures when I think about all the G's. 21. Memories in my head, the devil talking to me. Oh, I know Satan down that path, but God walking with me. Put your phone light in there.
Crabtree RV Center, leading the River Valley in sales and service for over 70 years. Founded in 1950, Crabtree RV Center has grown into one of the largest family-owned and operated RV dealerships in Northwest Arkansas. Located on 17 acres, including a 26,000 square foot indoor showroom, Crabtree RV Center has everything you need, all in one convenient location. Crabtree RV Center in Alma, Arkansas, making your family's dreams come true.
You know, we may not all agree on everything, but when we walk through these doors, we can have one thing in common, and that's Jesus.
With all the stuff going on in the world, all the good, all the bad, this church has been something constant for me and my family four generations back, and something that can stay constant for my kids going forward. They're still the same church, and they're still the same people that I can still depend on and go to when I need something.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Omega Car and Truck Accessories would like to invite you to come by and take a tour of our new retail showroom behind Brahms in Alma. Interactive working displays and a fully stocked warehouse allow you to pick out today's hottest accessories and get them installed fast. Wheels and tires, audio video, LED lighting, steps, lift kits, bed liners, custom interiors, towing, computer cut window tinting, Omega does it all. And with certified technicians, we guarantee the job will be done right. If customer service and value are important to you, choose Omega Car and Truck Accessories.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
Hey, I'm Brent.
I'm Dale, but you have to call me Dragon.
Well, then you have to call me Nightwing.
All right, Nightwing, let's play a little game. On the count of three, I want you to say your favorite travel center. Don't even think about it, just say it, all right? One, two, three.
Workman! What's your favorite deli item?
Chicken strips!
Do we become best friends?
Yeah!
All right!
Let's go to Workman's!
Workman's?
Yeah!
All right, now that we're finally here, what's your favorite homemade jelly or jam?
Peach jam!
Me too!
Yeah.
Wow, look at all the amazing honeys and jams, and all these other goodies.
Wow! Excuse me, ma'am, that looks delicious.
Oh, burger, that's my burger.
They're really good.
Yeah, that was amazing. Look at the wide variety of gifts.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Workman's.
Yeah!
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs. On-site insurance filing and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
Kevin Taylor, Matthew Farrell, Airwaves Media, we are back. Got the boys matchup coming up here, and boy, oh boy, got a dandy. The Airedales take on the Goblins, and this is kind of where it began, this turnaround for this program. Alma had come off a win over Watson Chapel at the Sheridan tournament. Should have beaten Sheridan. And a late call didn't go their way, lost by two, but then beat Watson Chapel and then started a seven-game January run with a win against Harrison at Harrison. That was on that Saturday. And the Airedales in that second half, they were down a lot at halftime. 8 points, and they rallied to win that game. They cut it to three right there before half, but trailed by as many as eight. They were down like 10-2 and 25-17, but they fought back to win it by 11 points and started off the seven-game win streak in conference. They've actually won nine consecutive league games going back to 2023. Alma won their last two conference games a year ago against Greenwood and Mountain Homes. So if they can take care of this game tonight, and stretch it to 10. And this is a tough league. This is a very, very tough league. So any game you can win in conference is big. It's going to be tough. Harrison coach, David Stoller, longtime head coach. Alma's actually gone up against him with a couple of different teams. He coached at Mena back in the day, and back when Stan Flinner was the head coach, they battled it out, and he took over at Harrison. He's done a great, great job with the Goblins. Alma's looking for a season sweep. They don't come very often against this Harrison basketball team. Harrison does lead the all-time series, but the Airedales trying to make some more hay in what's been a great start to the 2023-24 5A West basketball season. The Airedales trying to go 8-0 and keep their foot on the pedal. As we look at the standings coming into tonight's play, the Airedales 14 up, 8 down, 7-0 in the conference. The Goblins, they've won 4 straight. They're 4-3 in the conference, 16-7 on the year. Russellville and Van Buren each 5-2. Cyclones are 20-3, and Van Buren 16-7, and the Bombers also 4-3. They play winless Salem Springs tonight, and the Bombers 16-7, looking to make it 5-3. So some really, really good teams in the top half of that conference standing. Somebody's not going to the playoffs, so you got to play them one at a time. And boy, it couldn't go. Couldn't have gone any better for the Airedales to get off to that 7-0 start in conference play. Coach Dominic Lincoln's third year as the head coach has played a hard schedule, and he believes that schedule is what's got him here. He's got my blessing. They played Jacksonville a couple times, Lake Hamilton, Bentonville West, Sylvan Hills a few times. I mean, they played a tough schedule. So we're getting ready to meet this Harrison team. It's a good one. They've got some very good players. So it'll take a good effort again tonight for the Airedales as they take on the Goblins. And for Alma, a lot of balance, but really and truly, it kind of starts with the man in the middle, Israel Towns Robinson. All right, let's meet the starting lineup for tonight's game.
Good evening, basketball fans. Welcome back to Charles T. Dyer here in the arena. And tonight's conference matchup between the Goblins and Airedales. Enjoy! I'm the Airedales. This conference likes to introduce the starting lineup. First for our previous appearance today, the 6th grade senior, number 0,
Okay, let's meet the Airedales. David Wright, public address announcer, here we go. Camden Kerr, old school, three-sport athlete, football, baseball, basketball, gets a start. Ramani Smith runs the offense and does a great job of doing that. Miles Kendrick had a huge game on Tuesday against Van Buren, 19 points. Israel Towns Robinson. So you got 4 juniors and the sophomore, Easton Boggs. Easton's kind of the big factor in the fact that he's the shooter, but he's tall. He's 6'7", so he gets a lot of rebounds. If he kind of gets inside on that block, he can help him with a lot of offensive rebounds. So we're ready. Got an earlier start to tonight's game, about 7:25 Central Time, and this game's about ready to get going as the Airedales and the Goblins ready to get this thing going. Pretty nice crowd on hand. Not quite the crowd we had on Tuesday. Maybe a little less, but a good crowd nonetheless. And the tip is won, as usual, as he gets it to Cremonti Smith. And here we go. The Airedales have it. Camo night here in the arena. Cremonti Smith gets it outside to Kerr. It's a three-point shot for the Airedales. No good. It's off the mark. That was Miles Kendrick from way downtown. 7:40. The clock runs here in the first quarter, and here come the Goblins. Harrison's won four straight, and they're going to have to beat some good teams if they got a chance to get in this thing. Shot's no good. Rebounded by Easton Boggs. Cremonti Smith outside to Camden Kerr, gets it to Izzy. Back outside to Cremonti, going to launch a three. It's up, it's no good, and the rebound Harrison. So both teams are misfired from deep to start this game. 7 minutes and 5 seconds left. Here's a shot, top of the free throw line's good. Harrison takes the early lead, 2-0. One of the big things for this Airedale team, and we talked about it the whole year, has been the depth. That's just been a huge factor. And that really was on display when they played the first time against Harrison. Easton Boggs is going to launch a three. It's no good. So Alma's 0 for 3, all from deep to start this game. They trail it by 2 points, 6:40 left here in this first quarter. Alma got off to a, they trailed against Van Buren and then came back. Here's a shot. Good. So Harrison's up 5-0. Airedale's yet to get anything to drop. .620 to play in the first quarter. You wonder how they would respond after such a dramatic game against a good Van Buren team on Tuesday night. They're going to give Cremonti Smith a lot of space. He's not a shooter. He is the distributor. Here is Camden Curd. Got five on the shot clock. Alma's got to go. Got four on the shot clock. They got to hurry. Kurd's got it, puts up a fadeaway. It's no good, missed it badly. Great defense from Harrison. And Alma down 5-0. And a wide open three for the Goblins is up, and it's good. So a great start for the Goblins. So Dominic Lincoln calls a timeout. Cannot be happy with that start. Harrison 8, Alma nothing. Let's take timeout.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs. On-site insurance filing and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
Back in the arena, the Airedales down 8-0 early to Harrison. And just a lack of control on that last defensive effort. Here's a shot, a little lob inside, no good. Now, going to be a something called the other way, a foul called against Allen. Nope, they call offensive goaltending. No foul, just offensive goaltending. And so the Goblins have it back, up 8-0. 5:25 left here in the first quarter of play. Now it was 0 for 4 from outside. I think that was going to be a pass. Here's a three-point shot for Harrison. It's no good. A good blockout this time. And here comes Camden Kurd to Easton Boggs. Gets it back outside to Kurd to Cremonti Smith. Cremonti to Izzy. Izzy goes up, lays it up, and no good. But he'll shoot two foul shots with 5:06 left here in this first quarter.
Fouls on number four.
So Towns Robinson had 14 points and 8 rebounds in that win on Tuesday night. His first foul shots are on the way here in this first quarter of play. 5:06 left to go.
Checking in for Alma.
And the Airedales are on the board. Tyree McGill will check in for the Airedales. Easton Boggs will check out. And Tyree's been an X factor as well. He's played outstanding. Had a big offensive night against Mountain Home last Friday night. And had some big baskets against Harrison on Tuesday night as well. A couple foul shots for Towns Robinson. Alma down by 6, 8-2. Goblins working it around. Hayden Martin's got it. Outside it goes McNutt. Here's a three-point shot on the way. It's in and out, and the rebound right to Harrison. Right spot, right time. They missed it, though, and the rebound, Miles Kendrick. Here come the Airedales. Here's a three-point shot for Kendrick. It's good. Got the bounce. That baby rolled in and rolled out. Alma down three. It's 8-5. Miles is on the board. He has three. Going to have a reach-in foul called against the Airedales. Something called against. They got to talk in the scores table. .417 left to play here in the first quarter. No foul, just we're up high. I cannot hear the conversation, but they stopped the play. Harrison's got it, and they lead it by three. 4:15 to play in the first quarter. Here's a jump shot that's on the way. It's good. That's McNutt. His first points here tonight. And it is a 10-5 game. Airedales have it back. 3:51 to play. Three. Nope. Going to drive inside. Camden Curd off the glass. No good. Izzy puts it back in for two. 4 points for Towns Robinson. It's a three-point deficit. 10-7. Harrison by three. Jump shot for Harrison is no good and tapped out. Harrison the rebound. Got a new 35 as well. And the ball is taken away. Towns Robinson's got it for Alma. Gets it to Kermani Smith with 3 minutes and 5 seconds left here in the first quarter. Kermani in trouble, kicks it back outside. Tyree McGill lost the handle of it. And the Goblins with 3 minutes left have it back. 10-7 game, Harrison by three. 3-point shot for Harrison's no good. The rebound, Tyree McGill. Kermani Smith thinking about it, going to launch a three. It's up. It's good. Kermani ties it up at 10. It's a 10-2 run for the Airedales. 2:20 left here in the first quarter, tied up at 10. Boy, good defense from Tyree McGill. And pokes it away. He can play some defense. Here come the Airedales. Camden Kerr's got it. Curd in trouble, kicks it out to the Airedale's going to reset the offense now. Kermani was thinking about it. Here's Miles Kendrick back to Kermani Smith, going to launch his second three. It is no good in the rebound Goblins. Kermani 1-for-3 from deep, 1:45 to play in the first quarter. 3-point shot for Harrison's good. Goblins go back in front 13-10. And that's the first points here in this game from Martin. Airedales get it down low to Towns Robinson and going to be a, they're going to call a jump ball. Boy, not much time at all, but they give it back to the Goblins. Elmo's got some backups coming in. Eddie Tate will check in for the first time. Chris Salazar in the ball game. Matthew Rogers checks in for Alma.
Number 11, Lucas Paul.
Goblins have some backups coming in as well. Lucas Paul will check in for the first time tonight. 13-10, Harrison by three with a minute 15 to play here in the first quarter. Another long shot for the Goblins is good. That's a two-pointer, and Harrison goes back in front by five. It's 15-10. Here's Camden Kerr, lost the handle of it. Here come the Goblins. So Harrison led it 8-0. Up again by 5 and shooting for 3. It's up and it is no good. And the rebound, Harrison. And we got a whistle down low, a travel.
Checking in for Alma, number 15.
So the Airedales have it back. They trail it 15-10 with 45 seconds to play in the first quarter. Alma's going to hit the road on Tuesday night, and then, boy, a tough stretch after that. Russellville coming into town next Friday night. Chris Salazar going to watch a three. It's no good. And long rebound, Harrison. 25 seconds to play in the first quarter. Harrison by 5, and a chance to go up by more. Here is a layup, no good. Goblins put the put back in. They go back in front by 7, 17-10. 15 seconds left here in the first quarter. Here's a lob to Eddie. Eddie in trouble. Passes back outside to Matthew Rogers. He'll take a three. Matthew Rogers knocks it down. Big shot for Alma, and that'll do it. Here come the Goblins. Half-court shots on the way. It's no good. And after one quarter of play, Harrison 17, Alma 13. Let's take timeout.
You know, we may not all agree on everything, but when we walk through these doors, we can have one thing in common, and that's Jesus.
With all the stuff going on in the world, all the good, all the bad, this church has been something constant for me and my family four generations back, and something that can stay constant for my kids going forward. They're still the same church, and they're still the same people that I can still depend on and go to when I need something.
Kevin Taylor, and we are back in the arena. Goblins will have the opening tip here in the second quarter, and they lead it by 4, 17-13. Big three-point shot from Matthew Rogers. Alma trailed 8-0, tied it up at 10, and then they have fallen back behind after one quarter of play, 17-13. Good start for the Goblins, who come into this game with four straight wins, second longest winning streak in the conference, right behind the Airedales with 7. The Goblins have the opening possession to start this second quarter, and they have jerseys on that are tough to read. That is inbounding the ball, going to be William Southern. Nope, it's going to be Alma ball. All right, they forgot to change the arrow, so the Airedales have the opening tip. They did not move the arrow. No complaint from the Goblins. So Alma's got the first tip here of the second quarter of play. Easton Boggs checks in for the Airedales back in the game, and it's Rogers in Boggs. Salazar stays out there. Eddie Tate on the floor, and Hudson Boggs will check in for Alma. Here's a shot on the baseline. Good.
Field goal by Easton.
That's Easton Boggs' ball. First basket. Alma down 2. It's 17-50. Goblins get a pass inside. They throw it away. It goes back to Alma. 7:37 left to play in the first half. Goblins a little bit of light pressure in that back. They're looking to run a 2-2-1. So they're a 2-1-2. The Airedales are going to inbound it. Get it to Matthew Rogers, and here we go. 7:35 left. The left here in the first half, and a foul called against the Goblins. That's their first team foul of the second quarter.
Number 22, Hayden Martin.
Not a lot of fouls in that first quarter, by the way.
First team foul. Checking in for Harrison, number 23, Maddox Bell.
Almost got it out of bounds. 7:30 left here in the first half. Matthew Rogers will have it. That's the thing about this team. When you're going good, everybody kind of does their own thing, and they do their own role, and these guys are okay with that. Here's a drive from Salazar. No good. Eddie Tate fights for the rebound. It's going to stay with Alma. That's the second foul called against the Goblins.
Foul's on number 23, Maddox Bell. It's his first personal foul, second team foul.
Foul called against Maddox Bell, his first foul. He's a junior, 6'4" junior. Inbound comes to Tate. Everybody kind of got their role. Here's Matthew Rogers. Baseline pulls up jumper. We're tied up. 17-17. Rogers. Couple of big buckets for Matthew Rogers off the bench, and we are tied up at 17. Goblins going to launch an outside shot. No good. Rebounded by Eddie Tate. Under seven to play in the first half. Here come the Airedales across midcourt. Here's Easton Boggs. Kicks it back outside to Rogers. Salazar going to launch a three. It's up and no good. And the rebound is pulled down by Lucas Paul. He's not hard to miss. He's got the pink shoes on. I like that. 6.5 to play in the first half. Goblins and Airedales tied up at 17. These teams have had some battles over the years. Here's a wide open pass to Paul. He lays it up and in. Might have been 3 seconds in the lane, but nobody accounted for him, and he gives Harrison the lead again. They've not trailed here tonight. Almost tied the game a couple different times, but right now they're on the short end, 19-17. 6 minutes to play in the first half. Salazar turns around and shoots it. Tate the rebound. Here's a good pass to Salazar. Puts it up, up, and no good, but he'll shoot two free throws. Three team fouls now against the Goblins here in the second quarter. None against Alma. Chris Salazar, a chance to give the Airedales another tie. Chris had a nice game on Tuesday night. First one is good. Talked to the players during the week, and both of them, a lot of guys on Wednesday talked about they could not believe the crowd, the noise, and the intensity. It was just a lot of fun. It's a big arena, and it's more fun. There's more people here. Salazar ties it up. It's kind of hard to play in an empty arena, but when you got a lot of fans here, it's a lot of fun. Here come the Goblins in. Stolen away. Salazar going to give it back over to Rogers. Here come the Airedales. 5.5 to play in the first half. We're tied up at 19. Airedales looking for their first lead here tonight. They get a pass down to Izzy. Izzy turns, fouled. He'll shoot two. So Towns Robinson has 4 points and a chance to make it six. It's on Eli McNutt, his second foul.
Number 11, Israel Towns Robinson.
And Towns Robinson, a chance to put the Airedales in front for the first time tonight. 5:27 to play in the first half. And he missed badly on the first one. He'll get one more.
For Harrison is number 11, Lucas Paul, number 22.
So four team fouls on Harrison. None against Alma here in the second quarter. One more foul shot coming up for Izzy. And it's up. He missed them both, so the Goblins a chance to go back in front. 4 points for Towns Robinson. The Airedales are tied up at 19, and we got a foul going the other way. That's five fouls against Harrison.
Fouls.
That's an offensive foul.
Ball.
That's away from the play.
Foul.
It's going to be on the ball.
The
now let's see. I thought it might have been bonus, but I thought it was not bonus when you had the ball, but that was away from the play. But nonetheless, Airedales get it back. Salazar drives in, offensive foul. They called that in the girls' game a ton. That's something. I don't know if this crew is looking for that, but they called that a bunch in the first game. They call it here in the second game. That's the first foul called against Chris Salazar. And the Airedales give it back. Salazar going to check out Kendrick back in the game for the Airedales. Kendrick on the floor with Rogers. Hudson Boggs out there. And Israel Towns Robinson. They get a pass down low, stolen away by the Airedales. Here comes Alma across midcourt. Matthew Rogers drives in, kicks it outside. Kendrick for three. It's up. No good. Towns Robinson the rebound. And Alma throws it away. Goblins going to have a layup if they want it. Boggs on defense, count it, and a foul. Boy, that's a tough, 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 tough turnover. And a chance for a three-point play for the Goblins.
Fouls on number four, Hudson Boggs. That's his first personal foul.
Boggs picks up his first foul.
And basket is good.
The basket made
number five,
by Jackson Kreiner. And Harrison has not trailed, a chance to go back in front by three. They missed the foul shot. Towns Robinson's got his fourth rebound, and 21-19 with 4:35 left here in the first half. Goblins by two. Alma gets it down low, but they throw it away. They were looking for Izzy. Here come the Goblins on the run. Shot's no good. The rebound goes out of bounds back to the Airedales.
Hey,
Cole Cecil's had a heck of a game for the Goblins. 12 points to start this game. Camden Curry back in for Alma. 4:09 to play in the first half. It's a 21-19 game. And again, the Airedales can tie it up or maybe go back and take their first lead tonight. Curry looking for Towns Robinson. Got it to him. Izzy puts it inside. It's up. No good. And the rebound, Harrison. So Izzy not getting those shots to drop in tonight. And the Goblins a chance to extend that lead. Kermani Smith will check back in for Alma. And we got an offensive foul. Again, they called that a lot in the girls' game. Another moving screen.
Number 22, Hayden Martin. That's his second.
And the Goblins have it back. The Airedales have it back. Goblins on defense.
Checking in for Harrison, number 23, Maddox Bell.
So the Airedales have it, 3:40 left here in this first half, 21-19 game. Harrison by two. Easton Boggs thought about it, pulls up, 18-footers on the way, it's no good. And Harrison, good box out, and another rebound for the Goblins. 3:20 to play in the half, it's still 2-point Harrison lead. Alma trailed 8-0 to start the game. They battled back a few times to tie it. Here's a shot, no good. Another rebound for Izzy. Here's a long pass to Kendrick, who's covered up outside Izzy. Kendrick shoots the three, baseline. Good! First lead for the Airedales, 22-21, with 3 minutes left here in the first half. Here come the Goblins, 3-point shots on the way. It's no good, and the rebound, Towns Robinson, and a foul called against Harrison. Izzy's going to shoot two foul shots with 2:45 to play in the first half.
Lucas Paul, that's his third personal foul.
That is the third personal foul called against Paul. He's only been in the game for about this second quarter. So three fouls called against Lucas Paul and Towns Robinson, who's 2-for-4 tonight from the charity stripe. First one's up, and he missed that one. So Izzy's missed the last three. He'll get one more foul shot. Alma leads at 22-21 with 2:45 to play in the half. It's up, and he missed both. So four straight misses for Towns Robinson. And the Airedales, despite a lot of chances from the line, still lead the game by 1 point. But here's a deep three for Harrison. No good. And the rebound, Towns Robinson. Gives it up to Kermani Smith. 2:25 to play in the first half. Camden Curt on the baseline. Kicks it outside. Kendrick for three again. Got it! Two in a row for Miles. Timeout, David Stoller. Alma by four.
Timeout, Harrison.
Let's take timeout.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Kevin Taylor and Airwaves Media, we are back in the arena. The Airedales have themselves a 4-point lead, the biggest lead for Alma tonight, 25-21. Back-to-back 3-point shots for Miles Kendrick. And the Goblins, who led it 17-10, have been outscored here in this big run for the Airedales. It's a 15-4 run. It started at the end of the first quarter on that three-point shot for Matthew Rogers. So Alma trying to extend that defense and get the ball back up four. Harrison's got it. Here's a drive up and in. That's a nice move. And the Goblins snapped that run. That's 14 points for Cole Cecil. He's not hard to find. He's number zero on your scoreboard. Here's Towns Robinson. Up, no good. But again, he's fouled. And two more foul shots for Izzy with a minute 44 to play in the first half. And see if Izzy can shake off the free throw blues. He's two for six tonight for the charity stripe. 4 points for Towns Robinson. And the free throw, this one's up, no good. He'll get one more. Izzy just can't believe it. So one more for Izzy with a minute 44 left here in the first half. He's a good free throw shooter. This one's on the way and soft touch. Good. There you go, Izzy. 5 points for Towns Robinson. Alma by three, 26-23. Goblins have it. Here's a three-point shot's on the way. It's good. We're tied up 26 apiece. Almost got it back. Miles Kendrick. Camden Kurd's got it. Camden hadn't scored tonight. Camden gets it back again over to Miles Kendrick. And they got 15 on the shot clock. They get it down low to Izzy. Izzy spins on the baseline, puts it off the glass and in for two. Alma by two, 28-26, under a minute left here in the first half. See if they can get some stops here on defense. Shot clock at 30. Goblins have it back. They trail it by two. Here's a free throw line jumper. Good, no good. And the rebound comes down for Camden Kerr. Here come the Airedales. Here's Easton Boggs for three. It's good! It rattles in, baby! Bingo! Alma by five, 31-26. Goblins, three-point shot open. Baseline, no good. Rebounded by the Airedales. Kendrick's got it. Shot clock is off. 20 seconds to play in the first half. Alma's going to have a lead. Let's see what it ends up being. 31-26 right now. Easton Boggs with that basket's got five. And the Airedales taking the air out. 10 seconds left. Kermani Smith back outside. Kendrick lost a handle of it. Spins, turns, shoots, puts it up. No good, and that'll do it. So halftime in the arena. Harrison led it early, 8-0. But the Airedales have battled back, and they lead the game at halftime, 31-26. Let's take timeout.
Omega Car and Truck Accessories would like to invite you to come by and take a tour of our new retail showroom behind Brahms in Alma. Interactive working displays and a fully stocked warehouse allow you to pick out today's hottest accessories and get them installed fast. Wheels and tires, audio video, LED lighting, steps, lift kits, bed liners, custom interiors, towing, computer cut window tinting, Omega does it all. And with certified technicians, we guarantee the job will be done right. If customer service and value are important to you, choose Omega Car and Truck Accessories.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project become reality.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
Hey, I'm Brent.
I'm Dale, but you have to call me Dragon.
Well, then you have to call me Nightwing.
All right, Nightwing. Let's play a little game. On the count of three, I want you to say your favorite travel center. Don't even think about it, just say it, all right? One, two, three.
Workman! What's your favorite deli item?
Chicken strips!
Do we just become best friends?
Yeah!
All right!
Let's go to Workman's!
Workman's?
Yeah!
All right, now that we're finally here, what's your favorite homemade jelly or jam?
Peach jam!
Me too!
Yeah.
Wow, look at all the amazing honeys and jams, and all these other goodies.
Wow! Excuse me, ma'am, that looks delicious.
Oh, burger, that's my burger.
They're really good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Look at the wide variety of gifts.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Workman's.
Yeah.
Bro. Ça tue, ça blesse, ça flingue. Hey, hey, hey. Bro. Gazo. Ça tue, ça blesse, ça flingue. Aïe, 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 grip, bro. Gazo, aïe, aïe, aïe. Grip, clic.
Lumber One is a locally owned lumber yard located in Van Buren, Arkansas, down on Industrial Park Road. We've been in business since 2002, and our vision is to provide quality building materials to the professional builder and to the do-it-yourselfer at competitive prices. Lumber One offers a full line of lumber, unfinished and finished plywood, engineered wood, cedar products, and LP smart siding and trim, along with access to James Hardy siding and other pre-finished siding. We also carry roofing, insulation materials, drywall, and wood sidings like shiplap siding, cedar lap and gap, and car siding. Our full-line door shop can handle all your door, window, and trim needs. We offer several different exterior door and glass options from Therma-True, MAI doors, and Western Reflections. We also stock several different interior door styles from Gelled Wen, with access to their entire interior door line and others. We have a full-time estimator on staff who can do blueprint takeoffs and estimated material list for whatever project you have. He can work with contractors or homeowners to help you get your project started and answer any questions you may have. You'll also have access to an outside sales representative that will be there throughout the building process from start to finish. Our mission is to provide service at a level that differentiates us as the best in the marketplace. Lumber One, where service still matters.
Also going to have the winners for the gift cards and this quilt that they've got right up here in front of the scorer's table. They had a good drawing for that, and we have the winners. As soon as our minute is over, we will get to it. We've got 25 seconds left. Come on, girls, get in the stands. You're just walking around. Let's go. Hey, folks, they're a little bit out of breath. You might want to help them out. They got 10 seconds left. Five, four, three, two, and one. That is it. That's all the time we got, folks. Thank you for supporting the cheer team. And now we've got the quilt winner, Robin Crittenden. You have won this quilt. It's made by Phyllis Myers, who has made many Airedale quilts for us to donate over the years. And you can pick that up on the concourse. Coach Law will be up there to provide that to you. Also, a $500 gift card winner We would have some more half-court shots, but David Atherton bankrupted the bank on that one. Oh, you're not going to believe this. The gift card winner, Alexandra Atherton. It feels like a conspiracy. Alexandra Atherton, you got a $500 gift card from the cheer team as well. Atherton family's made out well this last week. $1,500 in prize money from the cheer team. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for supporting your cheer team. We look forward to seeing what they do out in Nationals.
Red Bull in my hands, feels like I got wings. Lot of people in my face, but I can't hear a thing. It's like my head's up in the clouds, heads up in the clouds, and I ain't coming down, no. Just turn the music on, just let me get lost. I swear that I'ma lose it if somebody turns it off. What are you, out your mind? You must be out your mind. Just turn the music on.
Well, 1.5 of basketball in the books. The Airedales lead this game at halftime 31-26, but it's going to be a tough second half. This Harrison team, they're tough, tough, tough. Won four straight games. And the Airedales trying to keep that run. Alma was down 8-0 to start the game. Dominic Lincoln burned the timeout.
The project graduation, 50,
they trailed 17-10. They fought back.
And we will draw that number in about
they close out the first
seconds.
Half with a 21.
Actually, it's already drawn. Just announce it in
to
about
9
seconds.
Run to take this lead at halftime.
All right, the winning ticket for Project Graduation
31-26, and good balance in the first half. 9 points for Miles Kendrick, 7 points for Izzy Towns Robinson, 5 points for Easton Boggs, and just everybody else kind of 3 points here, a couple points over here, 3 points for Kamani Smith. This Salazar, a couple points off the bench. I mean, it's just it's an effort.
Taken in this building tonight will go to support an Airedale.
And the Airedales at halftime have a lead. Matthew Rogers had a big three-point shot in that first half. In fact, he started that run. They were down 17-10, and Rogers hit a three to finish off the first quarter. And then the Airedales in the second quarter just really turned it on, outscored Harrison 18-9 to go up at halftime. Score of 31-26. But again, at 16 minutes left to play, the Goblins, according to the arrow, will have the first possession to start this third quarter. So camo night. I didn't realize we had camo in my house, but apparently we do. Landon's got a camo shirt on. Alma trying to win its 8th straight conference game to start the year. 10th overall. He won the last two they played last year. And halftime tonight, 1.5 a play, lead the Goblins by 5, 31-26. But the Goblins were tough out. Cole Cecil leads all scorers, and for the Goblins, 14 points. He's got 14. He's got half their points. 14 of the 26 points. Harrison's going to have the first possession. And the inbounds will come from Hayden Martin here to start this third quarter. And here we go. So the Goblins trail it by 5 points, and they got the first possession. And with the basketball, that's the guy to stop. That's Cecil, number 0. Shot clock at 15. Cecil's got it back. And a reach-in foul called against Camden Curt, I believe. Let's see who they call the foul on.
Foul's on number 3, Miles
Kendrick.
That's
on Miles Kendrick.
First personal foul, first team
first
foul.
First foul on Kendrick and the first team foul here in the second half. Inbounds comes to Harrison. 7:30 left here in the third quarter. And a strong move inside and up and in. Good play. Harrison cuts it down to 3, 31-28.
Field goal by Maddox Bell.
That's Bell with his first basket tonight. Strong move. 2 fouls for Maddox Bell, but he got that one to drop in. Here is Boggs for 3. It's no good. And the rebound, Goblins. Harrison a chance to tie it. Get a little bit closer. Here's a fadeaway jumper. It's no good. The rebound, the Airedales, but a reach-in foul called against Harrison.
Foul's on number four, Eli McNutt.
That's on McNutt. That's his third foul. So fouls were even at one apiece here in the second half, and the Airedales have it back. Seven minutes left here in the third quarter, and a pretty quick basketball night here. Got off to a little bit of an early start. Here is Towns Robinson up, no good. And the Goblins have a rebound. So Alma's 0 for 2 to start this second half. They started the game 0 for 4 in that first half. Here's a good backdoor cut up and no good. And a rebound, Harrison, a block, but a foul called against Izzy. And 6:37 left. The Goblins have a chance for two foul shots, and they can cut it to one right here.
Carmani Smith, that's his first personal foul. Second.
That's on Carmani, by the way. Picks up the foul. That's his first
foul.
Two fouls on the Airedales. Free throws up and good. Alma missed a lot of foul shots in that first half. Otherwise, they would have had a bigger lead at halftime. 31-29, one more free throw and it's up and good. Harrison trails it by one, 31-30. That's 5 points in the game for Martin, Hayden Martin. So the Goblins, first 4 points to start the second half. They trail it by one. 6:20 left here in the third. Alma got off to a really hot start Tuesday night. They'd led it by as many as 17 against Van Buren. Here's a backdoor cut to Towns Robinson. It's tipped out of bounds with 9 seconds to play on the shot clock. And after that big 38-21 lead, the Van Buren fought back and got within two a few times, but the Airedales held on. Almost got it out of bounds with 6:10 to play in the third quarter. They lead it by one, 31-30. The inbounds comes to Curd. Camden Curd spins inside, puts up a short shot, and missed it. So the Airedales 0 for 3. Here comes Harrison, a chance to go back in front. 3-point shot up and no good. The long rebound, Harrison's got it back. Another 3-point shot's on the way. That one's good. So the Goblins take the lead, 33-31. Seven straight to start this third quarter. Tyree McGill will check in for Alma. The Airedales come out a little bit slow. Really, the worst thing to happen for Alma was the halftime. They were gotten on a roll there. Shot clock at 15. Towns Robinson goes it up and in. Izzy, we're tied up at 33. Towns Robinson's got 9. So the first points here, the second half for Alma. Here is Cecil, a drive up and in. He's got 16. 35-33, Harrison goes back in front. The Goblins have outscored the Airedales 9-2 to start this second half. They only had 9 points in the second quarter. Romani Smith thought about it for a minute. He's 1 for 3 from deep. Gets it outside to Izzy. Back over to Boggs. Baseline shots up and no good. And the rebound, Harrison. Goblins by two with 4:44 to play in the third quarter. Three-point shot for Harrison's up, no good. The long rebound, Goblins, they get it back. Reset it again. Here's Cecil outside. Baseline shot's on the way, it's good. Harrison by four. So the Goblins have outscored the Airedales 11-2 to start the second half.
Field goal by Ryder Scribner.
And Alma down by four. Here's a shot inside, no good, but a foul called against Harrison. Two foul shots for, looks like number
foul's
one,
number
Camden Curd for the Airedales.
Third personal foul, second team foul at the line, shooting two. Number one, Camden Curd.
10 points now in the game for William Southern. Foul
check
shot
for
is good.
Number five, Jackson Kreiner. Checking in for Alma, number 33, Tyree McGill, number 24.
37-34. First points
five,
tonight for
Matthew
Camden Curds. And Cam up, and that one's in and out, no good. Eddie Tate over the back picks up a foul, and that's three fouls on the Airedales, so the Goblins have it back up three. 37-34, 4 minutes in. The clock's running. Clock's still running. Well, the Goblins catch, they run some clock there, and the ball out of bounds, and nobody stopped the clock. So the Goblins have it back up three with 3:45 to play. And a little bit of a break with a running clock there. Here's Cecil in the lane, up and in for two more. He's got 18. So the Goblins by five. Matthew Riders had checked in after that timeout. Tyree McGill in for the Airedales as well. Alma just a slow start. Here is McGill up and no good. The rebound, the Goblins get it back. Good hustle from Eddie Tate, but Harrison hangs on to it. 3:25 left, and Harrison here with 3:25 in the third quarter leads Alma 39-35. The Goblins, a big start to this second half, 13 points. Just three for the Airedales. Here's another foul against Alma, and two more foul shots for the Goblins with 3:19 to play in the third quarter.
Fouls on number 15, Easton Boggs. That's his first personal foul.
So the Airedales have fouled four times already in the third quarter, and the Goblins going right at them. That's kind of what Van Buren did. They attacked the rim. Free throw's no good. They'll get one more.
Scribner checking in for Alma, number zero, Chris Salazar.
Easton Boggs will check out. Chris Salazar back in the game for the Airedales. So we've got Salazar, Tyree McGill on the floor. Camden Curd's out there, and Matthew Rogers got four backups in the game. Eddie Tate as well. One more foul shot for Harrison. Hudson Boggs will check in after this dead ball, and that one rolls in and out. So Alma down five. They catch a break. They miss two free throws, and they've got it back. 3 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the third quarter. Harrison leads at 39-35, and the Airedales trying to get something going offensively. Here's a pass to Eddie Tate down low. Kicks it outside. Tyree McGill baseline spins. Puts it up and a tough shot. Eddie Tate the rebound and a foul. It's against Eddie. Wow, we're going back the other way. That's two fouls on Eddie Tate. And foul shots for the Goblins again with 2:54 to play in the third quarter.
Personal foul, 15 foul, places Harrison in the bonus.
Eddie Tate is tall, but I didn't really understand. In the first half of the girls' game, we had a fifth foul called. Maybe it was the boys' game. Anyway, there was a foul called. No free throws. And here, it's not on the ball, but it's away from the ball. It's going to be free throws for Harrison. So the Goblins have two foul shots coming.
At the line, shooting two is number 23, Maddox.
2:54 to play in the third quarter, and Harrison on defense has given up just 3 points to start this second half. Referee's going over to discuss it. They're going over to talk to Coach Dominic Lincoln. Eddie Tate's kind of done that all year. He's tall. Free throw's up and good. But not getting the benefit of the size.
Checking in for Alma's number four, Hudson Boggs.
Hudson Boggs back in for the Airedales, who trail it by 6 points. Eddie Tate, 6 foot three, plays a little, he's got long arms too. So 40-34, Goblins by six, and another free throw coming for Harrison. It's on the way, and it's good. Rolls in and out. Tate gets the rebound. So the Goblins missed some free throws late the last couple of times down the floor, and the Airedales have it back. Salazar passes down low, throws it out of bounds. Going to stow it, good to give it. Oh, goodness gracious. He threw it right off a Harrison player. Goes back to the Goblins. So 2:35 left. Harrison gets it back. Harrison by six. Alma just 3 points here in the second half. Here's a drive stolen away by Tyree McGill. And had it poked away. Here come the Goblins coming back the other way. And a foul called against Matthew Rogers. And for the Airedales, we're over the limit. Foul shots for Harrison. 2:22 to play in the third quarter. This has kind of been a situation. Normally, these Alma backups have kind of held their ground, but not so far here in this third quarter. Timeout Airedales. They trail about 6 points, 40-34. Let's take timeout.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Kevin Taylor and Airwaves Media as the Airedales find themselves on the short end, 40-34. And Harrison shot already 8 free throws here in the second half, and they're going to shoot 2 more. Eddie Tate, Tyree McGill on the floor. Hudson Boggs out there. Matthew Rogers and Chris Salazar. That's all the backups. And this has kind of been the MO. This is what Coach Dominic Lincoln has gone with, the blueprint, if you will. It's been working, but right now it's not. First foul shot's good for Harrison. And they get one more coming up here in this second half. They're up 7 points. This could match their largest lead. Free throw is on the way. It's up and in and out, no good. Eddie Tate the rebound. So another 7-point deficit, 41-34, with 2:17 to play in the third quarter. Pressure in the backcourt and a turnover. Alma keeps it. They get it back. And going to be a 10-second violation. I'm not sure how it goes 10 seconds when the ball was over midcourt, but apparently they give it back to Harrison. So the Goblins have it back, 2:09 to play, and a disastrous start to the second half of the Airedales. They trail it by 7 points. Tyree McGill almost got a steal. 2 minutes left here in the third quarter. Here's a drive down low, and it picked away by Matthew Rogers. Here come the Airedales. Rogers coming down court. Tyree McGill's got it. Spins inside, gets down low to Tate. Missed it. Rebound Goblins, and a foul going the other way against Alma. Goodness gracious. Boy, everything going right for Harrison. That's his 7th team foul on the air. Check it, 8 team fouls in this quarter against Alma, and more free throws for Harrison with a minute 42 left. So the Goblins have attempted, this will be 12 free throws in the third quarter. And that's, again, with that new rule, when you get the 5 team fouls in each quarter. If you get in trouble and commit a lot of fouls, the other team are going to get a chance to shoot a lot of free throws. Free throws up and good. Harrison by 8, 42-34. Towns Robinson checks in for the Airedales.
Also for the Airedales, number 3, Miles Kendrick.
Miles Kendrick back in for Alma with a minute 42 left.
Coming in for the Goblins, number 11, Lucas Paul.
Lucas Paul checks in for the Goblins. One more free throw coming, 42-34. Harrison by 8. Very stagnant second half for the Airedales. Been outscored 16-3 in this third quarter. Make it 17-3. So 43-34. Alma trails by 9 points. With a minute 35 left, so about 8.5 minutes left, to about 9.5 minutes left in the game to keep this thing going. Hudson Boggs feeds it down low, and it's stolen away. Going to be out of bounds. Going to stay with Alma. Airedales catch a break with a minute 25 to play in the third quarter. Only a 6-0 run, but it seems like a lot more. Here's a pass to Izzy, no good, but a foul called against the Goblins, and that's their third team foul here in the third quarter, and Towns Robinson going to shoot some foul shots. Izzy had a tough night so far, 3-for-8 from the line with the 2 more coming here. This will be 10 free throws for Towns Robinson in this game. Short on the first one, he'll get one more. Izzy just 3 out of 9. Got that one, and the Airedales trail it 43-35 with a minute 15 to play in the third quarter. Got to play defense, but can't foul. We're over the limit. Got an offensive foul going the other way. So nice defensive effort from Tyree McGill, and the Airedales have it back. Foul. 1:13 to play in this third quarter of play. It's a 43-35 game. The Goblins have outscored the Airedales 17-4 here in the second half. Kyrie McGill, cross court. Matthew Rogers, three-point shot. Big shot, no good, but a rebound, Izzy. Towns Robinson back up and missed it. The rebound, Airedales. Tyree McGill and one. So Tyree stayed with it, got it to go, and the Airedales trail it by six, 43-37 with 51 seconds left here in the third quarter.
15 foul. The basket is good at the line shooting one is number 33, Tyree McGill.
That's five fouls on Paul, who's fouled out. So the Goblins with five team fouls here in this third quarter. Each team has committed five fouls. Well, the Airedales actually more than that, but they only got five. So we're in the bonus in the last 51 seconds, both teams. Caleb Rory checks in for Harrison. We got a stoppage of play. So McGill a chance to cut it to five. 43-37, Alma trailed by nine a moment ago. Free throws up and good. Tyree, big basket and a free throw. And Alma trails by five, 43-38. 50 seconds left here in this third quarter. Student section up on their feet. And a foul called against Tyree. That's a tough one.
Fouls on number 33, Tyree McGill.
And free throws again for the Goblins. And McGill, that's going to be his second foul.
At the line shooting two is number 15, Ryder Scribner.
So free throws coming for Harrison. Seconds left here in the third quarter. It's a five-point game. The free throw is on the way. It's short, so they'll get one more free throw. That's 14 free throws in this third quarter from Harrison. That is a lot of free throws. Next one's on the way, and that one is good, so they get one out of two. 8 for 14 here in this third quarter for the Goblins, and the Airedales down six with 35 seconds left to play in the third stanza. Goblins are going to have the lead after three. Let's see what the Airedales can get a late bucket here. 22 seconds left. Towns Robinson kicks it outside. Miles Kendrick for three. It's no good. The rebound. Hudson Boggs has it. Outside to Tyree. Shot clock is off. 12 seconds to play. Tyree McKeel's got it. Spinning. Lost it. Gets it back to Hudson Boggs. 6 seconds left. They got to hurry. Here is Kendrick, a floater in the lane, no good, and the rebound Goblins, and that'll do it. After three quarters of play, Harrison 44 and Alma 38. We'll be right back.
Omega Car and Truck Accessories would like to invite you to come by and take a tour of our new retail showroom behind Brahms in Alma. Interactive working displays and a fully stocked warehouse allow you to pick out today's hottest accessories and get them installed fast. Wheels and tires, audio video, LED lighting, steps, lift kits, bed liners, custom interiors, towing, computer cut window tinting, Omega does it all. And with certified technicians, we guarantee the job will be done right. If customer service and value are important to you, choose Omega Car and Truck Accessories.
Airedales would like to thank Crabtree RV for their pregame meals.
Now 8 minutes left to play here in this basketball game. The Airedales trail this game by 6 points after three quarters of play. A big third stanza for the Harrison Goblins. They outscored the Airedales 18-7. Alma outscored them 18-9 in that second quarter. And then the Goblins came back with a strong third quarter and had a big run to go up by 6 points. It's going to be Alma basketball to start the final quarter. We're going to have the five starters in the game for the Airedales. Towns Robinson, Camden Curd, Kermani Smith, Miles Kendrick, and Easton Boggs. Here we go. So 7:55 to play. Alma trails it by 6. They get a lob down low to Izzy in the lane. Up and in! 12 points for Towns Robinson. Alma down 4. Well, the Airedales have found all kinds of ways to win games during this streak. We'll see what happens down the road here. Here's a shot, no good. And the rebound, Izzy. The bigger news is that the no more bonus free throws for a little bit anyway. Harrison shot a lot of foul shots, a lot of fouls by the Airedales in that third quarter. They get it down to Izzy in the lane. Izzy turns around, puts it up and in. 14 for Izzy. It's a two-point game. 44-42. Harrison by 2. 14 points for Israel Towns or Robinson. Three-point shot, Harrison up, no good, and the rebound, number 11. Here come the Airedales, they're running. Camden Kurds got it. Gets it out to Kermani Smith. Here's a three-point shot for Kendrick. No good, follow your shot, got it back. Passes back outside, could have had an offensive foul. Here is a three-point shot, bingo! Alma's up! Three-point shot for the Airedales, and Alma goes back on top. Camden Kerr from deep. He's got himself a big bucket here tonight. Alma leads it by 1. Here come the Goblins back outside. This is McNutt on the baseline. Covered up, gets it down low. Had it stripped away, they hang on to it. Cole Cecil, you got to watch him. He is tough. 20 points for 0, Cole Cecil. Got 5 on the shot clock, almost out of steal. And the Goblins throw it away. Alma's got it back. Great defense. Great sequence right there on defense. And Alma up 45-44. And a timeout for the Goblins. Full timeout. It's Alma 45, Harrison 44. We'll be right back.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project become reality.
Well, it's been a game of runs here tonight at the arena. The Airedales down 8-0. Had a big first half run, led it halftime by 5, then a big run for Harrison. They opened up the second half, a 17-3 run, 17 of the first 20 points to lead it by as many as 9. But the Airedales, down 43-34, have fought back and now lead this game 45-44. It's going to be on the ball in the backcourt. Doing it with a little bit of defense and some big shots in the lane from Izzy, Towns Robinson. Some of those weren't dropping in the first half, but boy, they're dropping here when it counts. Alma by 1, big possession right here. Kerr down low to Izzy. You can't stop him. Up and in for 2 more. He's got 16.
Towns Robinson.
Alma by 3. Goblin's going to watch a 3. It's in and out, no good. The rebound goes off of Towns Robinson. It's going to stay with the Goblins. Look like Kendrick got in there as well.
Checking in for Harrison's number 23, Maddox Bell.
So for the Airedales, to start this fourth quarter of play, it's a 9-zip run, 6 of those from Towns Robinson. They lead it by 3, and the inbounds comes to Harrison. 5 minutes and 40 seconds left here in the game. Here's a Here's a backdoor cut and a layup is no good. But a foul called against Alma.
Fouls on number 11, Israel Towns Robinson.
So 2 more free throws for Harrison. That's the first team foul here in this fourth quarter on either team. That one against the Airedales. Free throws on the way. It's good. So a three-point play. That ball did drop in, by the way. Three-point play ties it up at 47. 5 minutes and 5:32 left to play in the game. Kermani Smith thought about it. Alma's been going to Towns Robinson. He has been hot down low. Carmody Smith for three. Good! Big shot for Carmody, and Alma by three again. Boy, Carmody's got two of those tonight. 6 points, and the Airedales lead it by three, 50-47. Here's a pass, Harrison, backdoor up and in. Boy, it's tough, that last possession by Harrison. That was a 50-50 ball, went out of bounds. That kept that possession, alive. And boy, those second chances are huge. Alma leads it by one. They get it to Izzy on the block. Izzy puts it up and in. 18 for Towns Robinson. Alma by three. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left here in this game. Here's another lob inside. No good. And the rebound is taken down by the Airedales. Alma by three. Easton Box for three. Bingo! Alma by six. You betcha, boys. 4 minutes left, 55-49, and a timeout, Harrison. Alma 55, Harrison 49. Let's take timeout.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
Kevin Taylor and the Airedales have themselves a 6-point lead with 4:10 left. Harrison's going to have it at midcourt. Airways media tonight from the arena. The Airedales wrap up this 3-game homestand. And what's been a very nice, warm first Friday of February. Goblins have it at midcourt. They trail it by 6, 55-49. Alma trailed by 6 points after three, and they have opened up this second half, this fourth quarter, with a big run. Goblins have it back, trying to get it inside, and they get a backdoor cut up and in. That's good offense. Harrison trails by four, 55-51. And the Airedales have it back and had a steal. Nope. Let's see what they got here. Got a foul called.
Foul's on number 15, Ryder Scribner. That's his first personal.
That's against
foul.
Harrison.
First
That's their
foul.
First team foul here this fourth quarter of play. Both teams are guilty of one foul. And the Airedales have the inbounds pass to Kermani Smith. And here we go. 3:35 left to play in the game. Alma by four. Camden Curd, big three-point shot a minute ago, has got 4 points. Tyree McGill's re-entered the game for the Airedales. Going to give Izzy a little bit of a breather. Kermani Smith gets it outside to Kurt. Going to launch a three-pointer. It's up, no good, and the rebound, Harrison. Harrison trails by four, 55-51, with 3:05 to play in the game. Boy, tough and tight here in the 5A West, no doubt about it. Goblins get a backdoor feed. It's open. It's up and missed it. And the rebound going to be a jump ball. It's going to be Harrison basketball. So the Goblins hang on to it. Izzy going to re-enter the game after a bit of a breather.
Checking in for Alma.
2:51 left,
Israel
and he's back in.
Robinson.
And the Airedales 55-51 with 2:51 left. Harrison's got it out of bounds. And the inbounds comes. That's also another 35 in the shot clock. Here's a good move inside, up and no good, and the rebound up and in. Well, the offensive rebound came right to him, and Harrison trails it by two. So four straight for the Goblins after the Airedales took a 6-point lead. Kermani Smith to Izzy. Izzy had it blocked. Izzy back in, no good. Harrison the rebound. Allen leads it by two with 2:25 to play in the game. 3-point shot for Harrison is no good. And the rebound, Towns Robinson. Camden Curd's got it, and he'll pass it off to Kermani Smith. 2 minutes and 5 seconds left here in the game. Alma by two. Big possession right here, no doubt. Armani Smith passes outside and a foul called against the Goblins. That's their second team foul this fourth quarter.
Fouls on number 23, Maddox Bell. It's his third personal foul, second team foul.
So the Airedales have it on the baseline. The inbounds comes to Camden Curd. 35 seconds on the shot clock. Now at 30, here's a drive inside, up and in. Miles Kendrick, big basket for Miles. Alma by four. Here come the Goblins all the way. No good, but a foul called against the Airedales. That's a dribble drive, attack the rim.
Fouls on number 15.
That's number 15, Easton Boggs. That's his second. That's the second team foul called against the Airedales, who lead it by four, but Harrison going to shoot two foul shots. Missed the front end. They get one more. Well, they've had a lot of free throws here in this second half. Next free throw is on the way, and he got that one. One out of two. Alma by three. 57-54, the minute 40 left here in this game. Armani Smith across midcourt. Outside to Camden Curd. In the lane to Easton Boggs. Top of the circle. Missed it. Rebound Harrison. Goblins trail by three. A minute and a half to play in the game. They're going to take a three-point shot. It's on the way. It's in and out. No good. Rebounded by Camden Curd. Cam's had a nice fourth quarter to play. Minute 15 to play in the game. And a foul called against the Goblins. That's their third. With a minute 14 left, Alma's got it. And a fresh 35 on the shot clock. Three fouls on the Goblins, two on the Airedales here in this fourth quarter of play. They get the inbounds out to Kermani Smith. Kermani to Izzy, a backdoor cut, missed it, but a foul called against the Goblins. Their fourth foul, and Towns Robinson's going to shoot two foul shots with a minute 12 to play in the game.
Fouls on number four, Eli McNutt. That's his fourth personal foul.
That's a fourth foul called on McNutt.
The line shooting two is number 11, Israel Eli Towns McNutt. Robinson.
And two free throws for Towns Robinson. Timeout.
Harrison.
So the Goblins burn a timeout. What's ahead for the Airedales? Tuesday night, Alma's on the road. They'll be up in Benton County to take on the Panthers of Siloam Springs, back home next Friday night. And really after Tuesday night, the Airedales have a lot of, they don't have much travel. They've got some home games coming up in this second round to play with Russellville, Greenwood, Greenbrier. And then they'll cross the river. Well, not cross the river. They'll just cross the interstate a little bit down to Van Buren to take on the Pointers. Right now, it's a three-point game. The Airedales lead it 57-54 with a minute 12 left here in this game. So the Airedales at Siloam on Tuesday, back home on Friday, a week from tonight to take on the Cyclones of Russellville. Once again, good luck to the ninth grade team trying to finish out conference regular season championship. Eddie Quarter's team plays at Farmington Monday. That's a big one right there. The girls have a big one here as well. Coach Angela Rushing's team trying to get in the region tournament. At the moment you look in the stands, you see a guy with a Joey Bosa jersey on. Holy Toledo. Izzy at the line to shoot two foul shots. Been a rough night. He's 4 out of 10. But two big ones right here for Towns Robinson. He's had a monster fourth quarter for the Airedales. 8 points. First foul shot's on the way. It's up. It's good. Big shot for Izzy. One more to come here. A minute 12 left to play. Now the lead's at 58-54. Missed that one, and a rebound Harrison. So Robinson, Towns Robinson, 5 for 12, but the Airedales have a 4-point lead. 19 points for Izzy.
There's 1 minute left.
1 minute left here in the game. The Goblins, 20 seconds on the shot clock, trail it by four. Trying to set up 3-point shot. Looks like they get it. 3-point shot's on the way. It's no good. They get the rebound, up and in. 2-point game. And the Airedales get the inbound. Scrimani Smith and a foul with 39 seconds left. Alma by two. And Kermani Smith, two foul big free throws coming up here. It's a 2-point game, 58-56. Kermani Smith has 6 points in the game. Two big 3-point shots here in this game. One in the first half, one in the second half. And two foul shots for Kermani. That's five team fouls on the Goblins. And that is just two team fouls against Alma. Kermani Smith, two free throws coming here. I can't even speak here. First one's on the way. It's up. And you got it. Big one. Alma by three with 38.6 seconds left to play in the game. One more free throw coming for Kermani Smith. Got it. Boy, nothing. Nothing but ice in his veins right there. Alma by four, 35 seconds left here in the game. Boy, the Goblins almost traveled there. Cole Cecil passed it around. Goblins have it spinning. Put it up, no good. Rebounded, put back in, no good. Rebound again, no good. Rebound! Airedales have it! Kermani Smith's going to be fouled. Boy, that could be an intentional if they wanted to. 17.9 left. And Kermani's going to shoot two foul shots.
At the line, shooting two free throws.
Holy Toledo. What a game here. What a second half for the Airedales. Kermani Smith made it a 4-point game a minute ago. 17.9 still. Three timeouts for the Airedales, just one for Harrison. Kermani Smith's foul shot's on the way. It's up. Good. Kermani Smith. 9 points for Kermani, and they get a technical foul called against David Stoller of the Goblins. He's had enough, and that's going to be some more foul shots for the Airedales. David Stoller is the dean of coaches, and he's a good one. And he's obviously very upset on that last sequence. Kermani Smith will make shoot the free throw. It's up and good. Alma by six. And then we're going to get Easton Boggs for two more foul shots. 17.9 left in the game. And Alma's trying to go 8-0 in the 5A West. Missed the first one. He'll get one more. But the bigger story is the Airedales will keep possession. Got one out of two, so Alma leads it by seven. 17.9 seconds left. Alma trailed this game 44-38 after three quarters of play. What a fourth quarter. 25 points for the Airedales in this final quarter. And the inbounds to Towns Robinson. Izzy kicks it outside, and Alma's going to win this ball game, boys. How sweet it is! 13 seconds left. Clock's going to run. Run, clock, run. Alma goes to 8-0. And a foul called with 5 seconds left and free throws for the Airedales. Not only that, it'll be the season sweep for the Airedales over the Goblins, first time since 2005. This team just keeps finding ways to win. Free throw coming here for Miles Kendrick. Got the first one. You can say all you want to about all these free throws for the Airedales here in the fourth quarter, but Harrison shot 18 in the third quarter. Free throws up, and that's it. Alma by nine, and that'll do it. 5 seconds left. Goblins take a late 3-point shot. It's up. It's no good. And how sweet it is, baby! Airedales win it 65-56. What a second half for the Airedales. They come away with the win tonight. Alma goes to 15-8. Israel Towns Robinson, we call him Izzy. 19 points, a monster fourth quarter, 9 points for Towns Robinson, and another technical foul called against Stoller as the Airedales win this ball game 65-56. He wasn't quite done with the officials. This is Kevin Taylor for Airwaves Media. So long from Airedale Arena.
This time, your Airedale Pep Band presents the Alma High School alma mater. Fans, help us keep the arena clean. If you will take your trash to the receptacles up on the concourse, we'd really appreciate it. The Airedales will be back in action Tuesday, February 6th, as they travel to take on the Panthers of Salem Springs. We will be back home Friday, February 9th, as we host the Russellville Cyclones. Thank you for coming out tonight and supporting your student athletes. Please be careful driving home, and remember, there's only one Airedale. Go Alma!
Roll with me.